threats.
Slap you in the face, you know.
Mate, you've not got what it takes.
Anger.
Don't.
Desperation.
Dad, I need to find £2,000 within 5 minutes.
What happens when debt...
I'm not even paying a penny of it.
...tracks you down.
Don't open the gates, mate. We'll force entry.
Up and down the UK.
Can somebody come to the door, please?
We see Britain's most resilient High Court enforcement agents.
We need immediate police assistance.
Dealing with every debtor's worst nightmare.
It's not a wake-up call most people want.
Because if you can't pay...
Doesn't have a penny, doesn't own anything.
They'll take it away. Figures from a leading debt charity show that the value of total personal debt in the UK has risen by nearly £30 billion over the first half of 2017. A third of people who took part in a recent survey have seen an increase in their debts as a result of the rising cost of living. One in three admit that they rely on credit to get by every month. High Court enforcement agents Stuart McCracken and Elmore Victor are in Whitefield, Manchester. They have a writ to collect a debt of just under £4,000 owed by former pub landlord Paul Kirsch to a firm of architects.
Let's go see if he's in.
Let's hope he's in.
But this isn't the first time Stuart has tried to enforce this writ. Last time, Mr. Kirsch said he couldn't pay immediately and so was given 24 hours to clear his debt. But he didn't pay.
Beautiful house.
Let's go. Is this what they refer to as Manchester sunshine?
Now the agents need to get this case resolved for good, one way or another. With no answer, the agents go to investigate round the back of the house.
Hello!
Finding an open door, they make peaceful entry.
Is anybody in? Hello, Mr. Kirsch. Mr. McCracken, I come from the agent.
Yeah, okay.
Just stand outside. No, no, I'll be staying here at the moment, sir.
Please,
be
stand outside.
No, I'll be standing here at the moment, sir.
Despite his claims, this is where the notice of enforcement has been sent to, and where Stuart met Mr. Kirsch on his previous visit. Stuart makes his position clear.
We're here now to collect a balance of £3,916. If not, we are instructed to remove goods. I'll give you 15 minutes to try and raise the funds. If not, we will have to go around the property, sir, to...
Opportunity, yeah, to ring somebody, yeah?
Yeah, do that, just, then, no problem.
If you're not going to leave the house, sit down.
I'll be right near,
please,
sir.
Give me the opportunity.
OK, I'll give you that opportunity. Right. I'll give you 15 minutes, sir.
You can't just give me 15 minutes.
I can't do, sir.
It's not my address.
Sorry, you keep
I
saying that.
I've spoken to citizens' advice.
Yeah.
You can only take things that belong
That's
to
right,
me.
That's right, sir. Okay.
OK, this is not my television.
Right.
This is not my couch.
Okay.
This is not my house.
Yeah.
We're looking after the dogs.
Right, you
the dog's sick and he's got it ill. So I said I'd with the dog.
If you want to make a phone call and arrange a payment, that will be the end of the matter.
While Mr. Kirsch starts to make some calls, Stuart hunts around for evidence that the debtor is more than just the house sitter he claims to be. But Mr. Kirsch has other ideas.
How can you go wandering into another room? Can you hear what I'm saying?
I can hear what you're saying, sir.
Why
yes.
are you stopping me from making the phone call?
I'm not stopping you at all. I'm not stopping you at all. I'm not stopping you. I'm not stopping you at all. I'm not stopping you at all.
Stand there where I can
sir,
see you.
Sir, you can see me through the window.
No, I want you to sir. Stand there. You can't just wander in somebody else's
sir,
house.
Right, I'm going to make it clear to you. If you're not happy with what we're doing, ring the police.
What are you doing there? How can you look at other somebody else's information?
I'm just going to look, sir.
Please don't look at it.
I can do.
No,
why?
You can't.
Why? What have you got to hide?
Nothing.
You've got nothing,
got nothing to hide,
sir. OK, so I'll just continue having a look through here, then.
You will find that any information to do with me in this building
yeah.
has nothing to do with me.
OK. That's fine, that's no right. problem at all. But sadly, I can't take your word for that.
But then Vic spots a letter in Mr. Kirsch's name, sent to this address.
Address here, Mr. Kirsch.
I told you that I've been staying with my girlfriend and I'm looking after the dog.
So you are staying here?
No, I'm not living here. It's not my address.
And here's another letter here, sir. Royal Mail. Mr. Yeah. Paul Kersh. Why did your post come
here? Because I asked to send some post here.
Right. Sir, come on.
No, I'm telling you the come truth. On. Please, will you not continue looking, taking information? What are you doing?
Taking photos.
Honest to God, not my address.
You're digging yourself in a hole.
No,
sir.
I'm not giving myself
Look,
in a hole.
Some evidence here, Paul. Let's not go around circles. Let's get this thing sorted out, right? Let's
I'm trying to get it sorted out!
Don't raise your
But
voice.
You're then trying to be awkward with me.
I'm
telling you, it's not my home.
Okay.
Do I stay here? Okay. Yes. Do I look after the dogs? Yes.
Does your post come here? Yes.
The agents now have good reason to believe that this is Mr. Kersh's current home. Stuart's patience starts to run out. With the debtor getting more irate, he needs to get this case back on track.
Let's just nip it in the bud now, sir, OK? Give you till 11:15 to try and make some calls, try and get sorted out.
I'm trying to, but I don't feel comfortable you rooting around, and I'm telling you that I don't own this house.
Yeah,
and the property in this house does not belong to me.
OK. Right. Let's try and get it sorted, Paul.
Can't answer the phone, so all I can do is keep ringing.
Like I said, so we've still got time.
We always give the defendant time to raise the funds. Because it's a big shock. As you can imagine, someone knocking your door with a piece of paper saying, if you don't pay, we will take goods away. So we always try and work with defendants, give them time to ring a family member or a friend, because we all know someone that most probably can help us.
The clock is ticking. Mr. Kersh now has 15 minutes to find the £4,000 he owes, or the agents will have no choice but to remove any goods belonging to him from the house.
You've got the order with the value on it.
Yes, a copy for you, sir.
I need to make you aware, sir. If we do start taking control of goods, the balance does go up.
I don't want you to remove the goods.
No,
I want to make the payment. Give me an opportunity to make
the
payment.
We are at the moment.
Wait, can I give you £100?
No.
Well, what can I give you then?
The very minimum they would accept is 50%. That is £2,000. We can't put an offer forward for less than 50%. But we need to know a guarantee figure.
There's no point in ringing up a figure, sir, until you can raise it.
Up to the claimant at the end of the day to accept it.
Yeah.
I swear to you, yeah, that this debt, I have every intention of paying it because you people do not go away. You're like a rubber band. You're just going to bounce back again. Mm-hmm. The only way that you're going to bounce and not come back is if you get paid. Mm. Right, I get that.
Defendants will throw all sorts of smoke screens at us. But once they've realised they've used all their excuses, all their reasonings, they then think, right, well, I need to try and get this sorted as quickly as possible. It can be music to our ears sometimes when a defendant says, I know it's owed, I need to raise some funds, can you give me a bit of time to try and raise something? That's something that we want to hear on every job.
Mr. Kersh's time to raise some funds is almost up. With no sign of payment, the agent's only option is to start looking for assets to seize.
So I'm just going to go look around the property.
No, no, excuse me.
I will be, sir.
Danny, we're going to stop in your actions and make a payment.
Excuse me. You're not allowed to go around the property.
Of course I am.
It's not your house. It's not even. Excuse me. Excuse me. Please. Please don't start. Please.
Sir.
Give me the opportunity to deal with the situation. I understand your sincerity of your situation. I understand your job. But please don't go wandering around the house.
With Mr. Kersh now obstructing the agents from carrying out their lawful duties, the case has reached a stalemate. Stuart and Vic will have to use all their negotiating skills to get the £4,000 they came for. High Court enforcement agents Stuart McCracken and Elmore Victor are in Whitefield, Manchester, to collect a debt of just under £4,000.
Is this what they refer to as Manchester Sunshine?
The debtor, Paul Kersh, claimed he didn't live at the address.
Did you get the girlfriend's house?
Then he said he couldn't pay the full amount he owed.
Just... Can I give you £100?
No.
But when the agent started an inventory of goods, tempers started to fray.
It's not your house, it's not even... Excuse me. Excuse me, please.
Sir.
Please don't start. Please.
Sir.
Give me the opportunity to deal with the situation.
Now, Stuart must make it clear that he has every right to start listing goods for removal if Mr. Kersh doesn't make an offer of payment.
Please don't go wandering around the house.
At the moment, okay, I'm here now to assess
your
goods.
It's not my property.
But you're here, sir.
No, okay. I'm here.
So what I'll do is, I'll give you another 15 minutes to try and raise the funds.
I've not got it.
Right now. It's 11:30 now, I'll give it till 11:45, and then we will have to do an inventory.
With a second deadline set, Stuart has given Mr. Kirsch a final chance. Raise the money now or lose any assets in the house belonging to him. Mr. Kirsch gets straight back on the phone.
Hello? Hey. Just 1 second.
Yeah.
My brother-in-law's on the phone, right. And he says that... Can you ring somebody and check that if you can accept £2,000 as a payment?
We can do, yes. That's not a problem.
So can you pay £2,000 on your behalf?
Can you pay £2,000 on my behalf? Yes, he's saying.
OK, no problem. I'll make a quick call. There's no signal in here, so I'll have to go outside.
The balance. Can you raise it in 30 days from today?
Yeah, I've got to find £2,000 in 30 days.
So that's the offer, Stuart. £2,000 a day, balance in 30 days.
I'll see what I can do, mate. I'll see what they say.
Stuart goes outside to call the office to see if the offer of a £2,000 down payment from Paul's brother-in-law, together with an agreement to pay off the balance, is acceptable to the claimant.
His friends can pay £2,000 today. And then he's going to try and clear the balance in 30 days. Would you be able to check with the claimant and see if he'll accept that?
Okay, I'll get on the same plan. I'll give you a call.
No problem, mate. Speak to you shortly.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Yeah. It's very important to have a strong family network. I do feel for people that don't have that family network and don't have people to call, because you really are on your own. But on the other side of it, we're seeing more and more families coming together to try and help. Getting help from the family, it's only going to make you stronger.
15 minutes later, the office calls Vic.
2,000 today and the balance in 30 days, just to confirm. Yeah, OK, thank you very much, Mike. All right, cheers, Jay. Bye-bye.
The claimant accepts the offer.
The gentleman's going to make the payment on your behalf.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you our office number and you can phone them directly. What we're saying is basically balance of £1,916.74 to be paid by the 6th of July. You need to sign that you agree with that and that you're going to stick to it.
Right, we'll leave you to it, Paul. Brilliant.
Thank you.
All right, Bob, see you later.
It's a good result for the agents. But if Mr. Kirsch doesn't pay the money he owes within 30 days, they'll be back.
I'm not going to lie, Vic, I feel quite honoured by that. You just don't give up. You're like an elastic band once you...
Come back, you keep on coming back.
We call many things, but never an elastic band.
A recent survey has revealed that young adults in the UK are coming under increasing financial pressure. On average, 25 to 34-year-olds have a disposable income of just over £200 per month. And nearly 40% receive financial help from their parents. High Court enforcement agents Matt Highway and Gary Ball are in King's Norton, Birmingham.
As always, we've got our instructions from Her Majesty the Queen.
Yeah.
We'll carry them out.
They have a writ to collect almost £10,000 owed by Daniel Hutchins to a car finance company.
It's another big one, this, mate. It's a few hundred quid off £10,000. Big money to find.
Mr. Hutchins was paying for a new car he bought in instalments, but fell behind with his payments.
We're going to see what we can do, shall we?
Yep, see if he's in.
The finance company took Mr. Hutchins to court and won. And now he must pay the money he owes in full today.
Hello there. Can I speak to Daniel Hutchins, please?
Yeah.
Thank you.
He's just in his boxes. Can you just put some clothes on?
Oh, is he? Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Still in his boxes at 11:30.
Hiya, mate. You all right? Daniel, yeah?
Yeah.
How you doing, mate?
Yeah, not bad.
Should we come have a chat, yeah?
Yeah, all right. Of course.
I'm Matt Highway, High Court Enforcement. Gary Ball.
How you doing?
All right,
yeah.
We're about a High Court writ, mate. Does this relate to a car, does it?
Yeah.
Car
finance.
Right.
Yeah.
it's a lot of money, isn't it? I haven't got the money to pay, you know, and like I'm not working at the moment.
Anybody can help me with this or
not? I ain't got no one to help me. Like I ain't spoke to my mum for like 7 months. My dad won't be able to help.
So yeah. We're ordered to attend the property to either collect payment from you or to look at seizing goods.
Yeah, yeah.
This is actually my house. He's only recently just moved.
I've just moved in, you know. Yeah.
This is me and the kids.
Okay. Yeah. What the situation is there, unfortunately, is that because this is the address named on the writ, the onus should be on you to prove that the items belong to yourself. So if you do have receipts or invoices for them, we'll have a look.
While Daniel starts looking for sales receipts, Matt tries to find out more about the case.
Well, what's happening here?
It's just little cheap.
How long ago was this debt from, Dan? When did you have the car?
They took the car off me.
That's the repossession?
Yeah. I lost my job, which made me not keep payments to my car. Took the car.
What car was it?
Insignia. The car was originally like £8,000 or something. But somehow, even though I paid £5,000 and I've took the car, it's saying I still owe like £7,000. But I don't get how that works.
Daniel can't seem to find any receipts for the goods in the house, but he's keen to show Matt some other documents.
So I've got loads of debt letters, but they're all chasing me for them, but I can't afford to pay them yet. I'm not, like, because I'm not working, you can have a look around the house, it's not going to be nothing worth taking. I've got a van outside, but it's not
going to
be no use yet.
I'll have a look in a sec, mate. You're pretty honest with me, aren't you? I don't disbelieve what you're saying to me, so, yeah.
It's clear that Daniel has fallen on hard times, but the agents are duty-bound to search the house for anything of value that could be seized to offset his debt.
I'm going to have a look round and then we'll sort it out from there, right?
Yeah.
To be fair, this is a palace compared to some of the houses we're going to, don't worry.
There doesn't appear to be anything here of value. But then Matt discovers a letter from the Crown Court. It throws a new light on the case.
What's all this breach and suspended sentence stuff, mate? What's going on with that?
I went to Crown Court the other day. So I breached my community service. If I breach one more in 6 weeks, then I get 12 months in jail.
She's playing that, man. Get it sorted.
I'm off tag for like 2 weeks, guys. I'm tagged for 11 months.
There's only one way that's leading, isn't there, really? You know what I mean?
It was somebody originally that owed me money, and I found out where he lived, and then me and my went in his house without his permission and take all of my money's worth out of his house. Kind of like what you're doing without the licence. Yeah,
you have to get us to do that, mate. We can do that legally.
And then I got nicked for it, basically.
It seems that Daniel's conviction is at the root of all his money troubles.
So were you working when you took this finance out then?
I was a bin man. They come and arrested me from work, and then my gaffer turned around and said, look, obviously we're happy with your work and everything, but like, because of the council,
we can't,
you're going to be working around us, so we've can't keep it.
So that bit of daftness really has cost you quite a deal, hasn't it, really?
Everything cost me everything.
Often as a High Court enforcement agent, half of your job is an enforcement agent and half of it is a social worker. We will hear the full story about what the defendant's been through recently, been through in his life, what his situation is like at the moment. And they'll open up to you with these truths about their life in order to explain why they're in the position they're in. What it does for us is it builds a picture of where they are and how likely they are to pay this debt off.
With no sign of payment and nothing to take in the house, Matt needs to double-check the value of Daniel's van.
Is that the wheels? This one's yours, is it?
Yeah.
It's not worth £9,000, is it?
No.
Are you going for white or grey?
That door only opens from the inside as well.
There's nothing in there. With the best will in the world, that van's not going to cover us, is it, really?
I know.
At auction, the van would fetch less than £100. It's becoming clear that an affordable payment plan is the only way to get this case resolved today. But first, Matt needs to carefully assess Daniel's financial situation.
We can get this onto an arrangement, then, Dan. What are you suggesting? Weekly or monthly?
We've got paid £114 a week between us. It's a lot of money, so it's not even like it's a small amount of money. So I don't want to offend, but offering you a stupid little amount.
You get benefits, right?
Yeah.
What do you want?
JSA.
So it's 114 a week as a joint claim, yeah? All right. What are the debts have you got?
Loads, right? Loads, honestly. For what? I've owned a phone one for like nearly 700 quid. I've had a couple of old parking tickets that I didn't pay for ages, and I've spent hundreds of pounds. I've got another kiddies drawing, but I can't think of what it is. Altogether, I've got about 14 grand worth of debt, but when you're not working.
Yeah.
It's clear that Daniel is in life-changing levels of debt, so Matt decides to offer him a lifeline.
So, to get this sorted, mate, what I suggest we do, in light of your benefits, you know, job seekers and that, until things improve, we'll set it up at the lowest they allow me to, which is £50 a week.
I'm going to be honest with you, mate, it's probably going to bounce.
You can't make 50 quid a week with your window cleaning.
Yeah, we'll try, yeah.
Gary calls the office to see if the client will accept a repayment plan of just £50 a week to pay off Daniel's nearly £10,000 debt.
Alison, can you have a look at a job, mate? He's currently on job seeker's allowance, £114 a week. So he's offering £50 per week. Can you put that to the client, can you, and get back to us?
No problem. Cheers, Alison.
People do hide debts. Hide debts from themselves, hide debts from, you know, the people they live with. And when they've got two enforcement agents knocking at the door, I think it's a big wake-up call for them, and they have to deal with the situation.
5 minutes later, the office calls back.
Hello. Hi,
Gary, it's Alison. I've spoken to a client who's agreed to £50 per week.
Yeah.
On the understanding that review every 3 months, just to hopefully still keep up with it, OK?
No worries, I'll pass that on. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Cheers,
bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Do you hear that, Dom?
Yeah,
they've accepted it. However, they're going to do a 3-monthly review on it.
Yeah.
So if you do get a job, obviously you'll be earning more then, so...
Yeah, of course.
They'd obviously want more, so...
Yeah, no problem.
Well, you're going to have to get out, mate. Get out in the van and get some money made. You got things to sort out now. You got family and missus around you. You've got to sort it out. That's the arrangements in place, all right?
Yeah.
Any issues, give me a call. That's my mobile number there, all right?
Yeah.
Any problems at all, give me a shout. Cheers, Dan. Take care.
Good to see you, mate.
Right. Ta-da, mate.
See you later, Dan.
The case may be resolved for now, but as it's going to take Daniel almost 4 years to pay off his debt, there may be tough times ahead.
He's got a lot going on, hasn't he?
He's got
a lot going on. I mean, that suspended sentence hanging over him.
I lost my job because I'd done something stupid and ended up basically getting arrested like a donut, like just making bad decisions. Got off with the man of the house now and stop messing about, start paying my debts, and it fixed my life. But not take out stupid car finances or things that I can't afford.
Faced with a sensitive situation, Matt and Gary got the best result they could. But in Stuart and Vic's next case,
No, it's fine.
Fucking do one then.
What do you mean, do one?
Fucking
bell end. Yeah. All right.
All right, mate.
See you later.
They meet a landlord.
Every day there's someone trying to scam you from something.
On the losing side of a bitter dispute with his tenants.
Sash the house, rob the cooker.
Since 2007, landlords in the UK have been legally obliged to register their tenants' deposits with a government-backed tenancy deposit scheme. Landlords can't now keep the money in their personal accounts. However, the number of disputes over returning deposits to tenants rose to nearly 30,000 last year. ...8 a.m. High Court enforcement agents Stuart McCracken and Elmore Victor are in Liverpool. They're here to collect almost £5,000 owed by landlord Richard Downes to two former tenants.
Early morning start, Vic.
As always.
Why are we in Liverpool, Vic, this morning?
Liverpool.
Why have you brought me here?
We are going to visit Mr. Richard Downes. Outstanding balance is £4,941.
The debtor, Mr. Downes, failed to give the tenants their deposit back after they moved out of his property.
It's that house in the corner, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let's go and have a chat.
The case was escalated to the High Court, and now Mr. Downs must pay back the money he owes in full today.
Good morning, you okay? I'm after Richard. Richard Downs.
He's not here.
He's not here. He does live here, though, doesn't he?
Just woke
up. Oh, right, okay.
Been on lethal, right?
Oh, I do apologise. He does live here, though, doesn't he?
He does. Why? What's wrong?
Right, okay. Well, we're High Court enforcement agents. Are you able to give him a quick call?
No, I've just told you, love.
Well, you can see you've just woke up. Right, well, we need to speak to him.
You want me to get hold of him?
If you can, yeah. That'd be great.
The woman goes to fetch her phone, and the agents make peaceful entry into the house.
Is it your son or your husband? What's the relationship?
My son. Don't be walking in your house, love.
No, we'll be waiting here.
We'll wait here. We won't go any
further. I won't let no one go in with no shoes on.
Yeah, yeah. Do you want me to close the door for the eating or leave it open?
Yeah, you know. Right.
We'll stay here for the minute. Is he in work?
He goes out early, love.
Mr. Downs's mother gets him on the phone.
You better get round here. I've got two guys here.
Is he on his way, is he? Do you know how far he is? Where over he is?
I never know. I wouldn't like to be doing your type of job, love.
Some people disagree.
Someone has to do it, I tell you what, I wouldn't be able to sleep at night.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure the claimant feels exactly the same. Debt follows you around. It affects other people, not just the people that we're after. They're involved whether they like it or not. It's heartbreaking in a way.
2 minutes later, Mr. Downs arrives. But instead of coming inside to speak to the agents, he phones his mother.
Yeah? It's a High Court, Rich.
You want to speak to me?
There you go, but there's the case there.
Hi, good morning. Is that Richard Downs?
Speaking, yeah. This is what happens. And I've got a counterclaim against them, what waiting to be dealt with now.
At the moment, sir, I'll explain to you, it's a CCJ against yourself, a county court judgment, right? Because it's not been paid, they've transferred that CCJ to the High Court, right? We've got now a writ of control here today to execute. The outstanding balance is £4,941. All money paid today is held for 14 days. You can still have a counterclaim. I've got no problem with that, but we need payment on this case today, sir.
Well, listen, it's impossible because the money wasn't there to be paying you today for starters because we've got a counterclaim for over three grand.
We will have to remove goods then, sir.
You won't be moving no goods, mate?
We instructed under the High Court. It's a writ of control, sir, and it's at this address.
Listen, I am. Respectable landlord, yeah? Respectable landlord. This claim got lodged weeks and weeks back and I'm waiting to hear back from it. I've had no notice to pay you in full, right? I'm going to get the solicitor on the phone now because this isn't right.
I can talk to the solicitor, but he's not going to change the situation.
Finally realising the seriousness of the situation, Mr. Downs rushes in.
I'll share my ID first, mate. My name is Mr. Victor, I'm a High Court Enforcement Agent. That's my colleague, Mr. McCracken. It's a High Court writ. I appreciate you've got a counterclaim, but at the moment, this balance...
We've had no notice of yous, of the court, to pay yous in full.
That's the notice of his horse was sent on the 5th of the 11th. We won't be here by law if it hasn't been sent.
No, it hasn't come through my door, that.
What's actually regarded?
Every day there's someone trying to scam me from something. They're just opportunists, the tenants. Tenants in my house, moved in 2009, Left in 2012. Trashed the house, robbed a cougar. Because I never put a deposit in a DPS, the judge granted them,
Because Mr. Downs didn't put his tenant's deposit in a government-registered scheme, the judge found against him, and he must pay in full today.
I'm in a position to pay £4,000, though, so...
We need the payment in full. That is the bottom line. That's what we've been instructed. If not, we have to remove goods.
With payment looking unlikely, Stuart goes outside to take a look at the van Mr. Downs arrived in. But a neighbour has spotted him from an upstairs window.
Hey, you. That's not even yours, yeah.
You what, mate? What do you mean?
It's not yours. Shut the door.
Whose is it? Whose is it? Whose is it? Whose is it?
Never mind, who's it?
Whose is it?
It's mine, so shut the door on the van.
Yeah, no problem, mate.
Off my fucking path now.
Is this your van, is it?
It is my van. So
no problem. No, that's fine. No problem. If it's your van, that's fine. No problem.
That's my fucking
No, it's fine.
Van.
No, it's fine.
Do one, then.
What do you mean, do one?
Bell-in.
Yeah. All right. All right. All right, mate. See you later.
But as Mr. Downs arrived home in the van, Stuart is suspicious of the man's claims. So he calls the office to see if it's free of finance.
Hi, Nicky. Can someone do HPI for me, please? Yes. Under 1,350 quid. Okay. Cheers, John. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.
The vehicle is free of finance and can be seized. So now Stuart needs to confirm his suspicions that it does, in fact, belong to Mr. Downs.
Have you got documents for the vehicle?
Yeah, documents.
Yeah, because obviously we've seized that vehicle, now it will be removed.
You just took my vehicle?
Yeah.
No, it's not. It's still here.
It's still here, but we've taken control of it.
So I'm to take the vehicle just to get you out of my ear for now and go from there, cool.
It appears that the van is the debtor's, but its value doesn't come close to clearing the £5,000 owed. So the agents may have to seize assets from the house to offset the balance.
But we're here to take control of goods as well, so it'd be in the property as well. We will be removing goods.
But then a friend of Mr. Downs arrives, and it appears he's willing to pay some of the debt.
So can you take half of the money out?
Half the money out and then cut back for half.
It needs to be the full balance,
guys.
I know you're trying to source it out.
Listen, I'll give you half cash now, but come back for the other half.
All right, if you got half cash, can you pay that off on your card?
I haven't got a card.
So, look, we get half, and then when can you come back for the other half? When you come back tomorrow?
We can't. We're here today for the full balance. I appreciate you want to help your friend, but we instructed to collect the full balance or take control of goods, which means removing goods.
What is it now?
4-9.
4-9-4-1.
Mr. Downs and his friend leave to try and get the rest of the money.
We can usually tell if someone's going to return with the cash because they've made the effort to come all the way down. They know the situation, they know why we're there, they know what's going to happen if they don't make the payment, and then they've offered to help the friend. So, in my opinion, the last thing they want to do is let the friend down.
Just moments later, Mr. Downs and his friend come back.
So, how much is it?
4-9-4-1.
And they've bought a bundle of cash.
Let's quickly count this out, guys, and then I'll leave you to it.
Thanks to the help of his friend, Mr. Downs's debt is paid off in full.
135, yes, well.
All your details are in there, what you need. Paperwork, copy of the writ.
There you go, guys. Got the details in there.
All right, guys.
The agent's perseverance has paid off.
Result?
Yeah, cracking work, Vic. Cracking work.
Recent research shows that there are currently almost 5 million self-employed workers in the UK, and in the last year alone, they contributed over £250 billion to the economy. However, 4 in 10 self-employed workers can't afford to save any money at all each month, making them more likely to fall into serious debt. ...7 a.m. High Court enforcement agents Gareth Short and Mitch Starr are in Swindon, Wiltshire, to enforce a writ against self-employed builder Martin Riley.
Where are we off now, mate?
Off into Swindon, mate, to visit a Martin Riley. £2,060.49.
Mr. Riley fitted a kitchen in the claimant's home, but she was unhappy with the standard of his work.
Any notes on it?
Apparently he's in dispute to have the kitchen set aside, but hasn't paid the court fee yet.
The claimant hired another builder to finish the job and then got a county court judgment issued against Mr. Riley to recoup her costs.
This don't look too bad.
It looks all right, this does.
to it, mate.
The case was escalated to the High Court, and now Mr. Riley must pay the £2,000 he owes in full today.
Door's open.
Hello?
The agents take the opportunity to make peaceful entry through the open door.
Hello? High Court enforcement agents. Marden, can you come down, please?
Come on. It's all right. It's all right, buddy.
Hello?
Can I have a look, bud?
Hello?
But no one appears to be in. So Gareth checks upstairs. And he's in for a surprise.
Ooh. Hello, sir. Marden, is it?
Yeah, can you go downstairs, please?
Yeah, of course we can. No problem. No problem.
How did you get in?
The door's open, sir.
Don't need permission, sir. We're with the High Court, Red.
Come on. Here you go. Marden. Marden, High Court enforcement agents.
Yeah.
Here to execute a High Court writ against you, unfortunately, sir.
Well, I've already got a stay writ on it.
Has it been set aside?
Well, it's been sent.
Then, Marden,
have you? I paid for it.
Okay.
Have we been given a date to set it aside?
Swindon County Court.
Have you been given a date to set it aside, sir?
I'm trying to find the letter.
Okay.
Do you know where the letter is?
Mr. Riley's wife comes to help him look for documentation about his appeal.
Thank you. So, all this is just to say, yeah, we acknowledge the application, but it's not been set aside. So until you get given a date and a time to go in front of the judge, then unfortunately this High Court writ is still outstanding. So unless the full balance of £2,060.49 is paid to us right now.
£2,000?
Yeah, you've incurred additional enforcement costs now.
This is a joke. The bloke owes me money.
With Mr. Riley disputing the writ, this simple case might be tougher to crack than Gareth and Mitch expected. It will take all of their patience to get the £2,000 they came for. Gareth Short and Mitch Starr were in Swindon to recover £2,000 owed by self-employed builder Martin Riley to a dissatisfied client.
How'd you get in? The door's open, sir.
Mr. Riley claimed he'd appealed the case.
I've already got a stay writ on it.
And said he'd been treated unfairly.
This is a joke. The bloke owes me money.
Now the agents need to make it clear that despite the dispute, the debt must be paid today. But Mr. Riley is keen to tell them more about the case.
This is why I'm contesting it. He still owes me money. I installed a kitchen. I fitted the job in for him because she was desperate. So I went round, had a look. I said, look, I've got jobs booked in, but I might be able to fit you in, but I am squeezing you in, and I'm on a time limit.
Do you a favour and squeeze you in, is it?
Yeah. So I went there, give them the price, started the job, and then she started adding things. Oh, well, I want this done, I want that done. I ran over by a week as it was because of the extras I did for her. I sent them an invoice. For the extras I'd already done, which come out at £500 and some, and they owed me about £120 from the original job.
Yeah.
Well, next thing, he's saying that I haven't done all these things, i.e. moving sockets, doing this, doing that, and everything. I said, well, that wasn't in the job.
So what, are you a kitchen fitter, are you, or general builder?
I'm a general builder, but mainly kitchens and bathrooms.
Yeah, yeah.
I said, well, I'm not coming back until you pay me my money.
Yeah.
He said, I'll take it further. I said, well, you do what you've got to do.
Of course. Problem you've got is they've provided enough evidence to a county court judge that you do this owe this money.
Despite his dispute with the claimant, the agents are duty-bound to resolve this case today.
Unfortunately, as it stands at the moment, unless the debt is paid,
I haven't got that sort of money.
The position you're in at the moment is if it's not paid, assets will get removed from you today.
So at the moment, your balance stands at £2,060.49.
Probably haven't even got stuff in his house worth that.
So the position you're in now, if it's not paid...
I can't pay it. I haven't got £2,000. I'm just going to get my phone.
OK.
Do you have any family or friends that can help you out, Martin?
Do You always go to bed and leave the front door open? It's going to work, see? We often get debtors and defenders who are just fixed on the original judgment, why they're in that problem in the first place. Don't get me wrong, I listen to the story all day, but I'm there to get a result. So what I try and do is listen to their story, but bring them back down to the ground and say, I'm not there to deal with disputes, unfortunately. A county court judge has already agreed that you owe this money. You might as well work with me, get the debt resolved.
Realising the agents aren't going to go away, Mr. Riley gets his mother on the phone.
Sorry to wake you. You're right. Do you want me to give you 5 minutes to wake up? Well, you know that asshole that took me to court. I got 2 High Court bailiffs stood in my front room. Can you lend me some money? Well, it's over 2 grand. What happens when I pay this? If I go back to court and I win, do I get this back?
As long as you get your date within the next 14 days, that money will be held until the end of your court case. If you win, you get the money back.
I know I ain't going to lose. You plug my head in. I'm out there trying to earn frigging living and you've got people like him trying to fucking walk all over me. Sorry, Mum. Yeah, are you able to help me out? So I'm not going to not give you it back, have I? I just need to get this sorted out.
It seems that Mr. Riley's mother is willing to pay her son's debt.
Sorry about this, Mum. Have you got your card handy? You'll need your card. All right. Sorry. What's the code on the back of the card?
If it's a savers account, perhaps he hasn't got it.
Everyday saver card.
Right, we can't use that card, Mum. Do you know how to transfer it?
No.
Right, I'm going to pass her on to...
You carry on, mate. You do what you've got to do.
Might as well sit down.
We've been driving in a while, thanks. It's nice to stretch the legs.
It appears Mr. Riley's mother needs to transfer money from one account to another, but she doesn't know how to go about it.
This could be hard work.
Yeah?
My mum lives on her own since my dad passed away, so... Right. Dad passed away 2.5 years ago. She'd never even had anything to do with a bank account, so we've had to sort of try and teach her.
Yeah. Your wife's talking her through it now, is she?
Right.
No matter what somebody's age is, if they phone their parent and instinct is to help them out. I'm a parent myself. I'd never want to see my son in debt or ultimately have assets taken from him. So I know from first-hand experience I would do anything to help my son out. And I'm just guessing it's the same across the board.
15 minutes later, with the money transferred into another account, Mr. Riley calls his mother back.
Right, we need your card. You got your card?
Yeah.
He gives the card details to Gareth.
2064, yeah.
Just stick that through. There we are.
Bye, man. Right, that's all sorted. Thank you. Love you.
Love you.
All right, sorry for waking you. See you later. I'll pop round later.
Just take a picture of that, buddy.
Thanks to his mother, Mr. Riley's debt is paid in full.
Here we are, buddy. It's all sorted.
All right, cheers.
Hopefully we won't see each other again, mate.
No.
Thank cheers. You very much. You take care, all right?
Yeah. I'll let you know when I win.
Yeah. Lock your door in the future, mate.
Yeah.
I thought it was all taken care of. Obviously, I was wrong. My mum's tops. Couldn't fault her. But I can't say too much because I'll end up blubbering because my dad passed away a couple of years ago, so, yeah, I love her to bits.
I felt a bit sorry for her because she struggled to transfer the money and everything, but we got there in the end. He was a decent enough guy. So, see what happens in court now, won't he?
Can't Pay is back new next Thursday at 9. How good are fake documents and who's making them? Paul Connolly's Undercover Nailing the Fraudsters, new next on Channel 5. Whilst next, over on 5 Spike, head behind bars in Dallas, Texas, one of the world's toughest prisons.